Thunder.
Who are we?
We are
na 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 na
Budapest, my hidden treasure chest, golden grand piano, my beauty focus EOU. Ooh, you, ooh, I'd leave it all.
I kind of want
my acres of a land I've achieved. It may be hard for you to stop and believe, but for you, ooh, you, ooh, I'd leave it all. Ooh, for you. Ooh, you, ooh, I leave it all.
Happy birthday to you.
Well, you're big wish.
Okay,
good. Head coach Carl Wiersma celebrating his birthday before the game, a win, and the Lady Raiders celebrate his 500th career coaching victory afterward.
The heart is a blue, shoots up through the stony ground. There's no room, no space to rent in this town. You're out of luck.
Plus
a good feeling, yeah.
Coach, we got a bachelor
party.
Yeah, we got a bachelor party at my house. Anyone wants to come to the final night?
Being a part of the Ride a Girl soccer team has meant a lot to me, because I get to be a part of a strong unit and I get to grow as an individual.
Being a part of the Rider soccer program means to me to stay committed to the team no matter how hard it is, and to be selfless and to support every girl on the team.
Being a part of the Rider girl soccer team has made me feel appreciated and part of something really fun and great.
Just the love that we have for soccer. No matter if we were up or down, we still put our all into it.
Dreams coming true, because like the little girl inside of me, that little soccer player, I would always watch the Rider girls play, and I just loved it, because like the competitiveness, the aggression, like all of it, it was amazing. And I loved it, and that's the kind of player I was, and I just could not wait to be a part of it. Like, I thought it was gonna be like it, the coolest thing ever. And it's just, I was not a loser either. Like, anyone who knows me knows, like, I don't lose. I don't like to lose. Like, losing is not in my vocabulary. And, like, the Rider soccer program, they don't lose. They're not known for losing. So just to be a part of it, to be a captain, like, I did more than making that little girl's dreams come true by being a part of this program.
Enjoy every moment you get on that field, because you'll never know when it's going to be your last.
To never take things for granted and to always cherish the time that you have, and also to find friend groups that you know will last a lifetime.
Always be yourself and always do what makes you happy, because at the end of the day, that's all that matters. And live your life to the fullest with no regrets.
Go kick some butt. And don't let this year hurt you in any way. Because next year, y'all are going to go to state.
All in. So if you're messing around at practice, just try to snap back into taking it seriously at the same time. Because if you're not, you're just wasting everybody's time. And if there's any bigger pet peeve than someone parking next to a stop sign for me, it's people getting out there and not taking anything seriously and wasting everyone's time. I'm sure everyone else said something really inspirational and positive. Like, stick together, love each other, that's important too, but it's also very important that you know the reality of a varsity level sport. Get out there, work your butt off, and don't waste anybody's time, because I'm going to MSU for the next 4 years and I will be showing up to games and making sure of it. I'll be there. So don't waste my time either. But I've loved everybody, and I hope everyone has an awesome time in the next however many years to come.
When we were playing indoor, and Mia was running, and she just tripped and fell over the ground. That was really funny. And then when Kiki got hit in the eye, because that same game I was sitting on the bench with her and it didn't even look like she was looking at me. So that was really funny.
About to get put in goal for Ryder Old High and getting to walk on the field with all my teammates.
Would probably be coach trying to play soccer with us. And when Mindy kicked the ball at Haley's face.
During one of the tournaments, whenever me, Kinsey, and Bella were in our hotel room trying to learn how to do the Renegade.
Two of them. Can't pick. Mindy might say it. The time coach tried to teach us how to do a side volley, swung and missed, fell. I mean, now that I think of it, I think life lesson, no matter how hard you swing and miss and fall, as long as you get back up, it's all that matters. It's perspective, ladies and gentlemen. Perspective. But I would have to say my all-time favorite memories is stepping onto that bus knowing coach was behind the wheel. The adrenaline that gives you, unreal. Unreal, I'm telling you. I mean, no telling how many times I almost hit the ceiling, flew into the seat next to me, into the floor. No telling. But I need to give a specific example. I'm sorry to call you out like this, coach, but I will never forget it. We are flying down the highway. Flying. We need to make a left turn across traffic. Okay? In order to make a left turn, you have to, you know, make sure no one's coming. People were coming. Coach doesn't care. I think this was a lesson coach was trying to teach us about commitment. I mean, you gotta fully commit or not at all. Go big, go home. He makes a left turn. And I mean, here in Texas, no one drives the speed limit. So I'm sure these trucks were going at least 80, 85 miles per hour. And I mean, my window is facing them. He makes a left turn and stops. Stops in the middle of the road. And these trucks are at my window. I thought, God, please make this as quick and painless as possible. Please, if you're gonna take me out, make it fast. Because he stopped, reversed, adjusted himself, and went in a bus on a freeway. I have goosebumps. But that's it. That's the best one.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth.
Don't say anything. No one should be surprised at this. Nobody. Quarantine has... It got to me, okay?